Hey, what's up guys? In this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the color mixer tool. So the color mixer tool allows you to make changes to specific colors in an image. This image I took of a museum in Panama City. So the options are you can change the hue, saturation, as well as the luminance. So for example, let's say I want to change this orange and I want to change the hue. I can go to the hue section, go to the orange slider and make it more yellow, or I can make it more red. The one thing is when you're selecting these colors, it can impact different parts of an image. So this example, this orange, which was originally orange, also turned red. So you gotta be careful when you're selecting or playing with the color mixer tool. And let's say with the saturation of the orange, I can increase it or I can decrease it. And then I can also change the luminance of the orange by increasing it or decreasing it. So let me just make a subtle change to the orange here, make it more saturated, and change the hue a little bit. So that looks pretty cool. Let's see the before and after of the orange. Another thing I can do or use is this eyedropper or picker, color picker tool. I can select it. Let's say I want to make this green or this grass more saturated. So I go to the saturation section. Then I click drag here and then I can increase it. So I'm scrolling or moving my mouse up. But the one thing you may notice is it selects the green and increases saturation, but there's also some yellow in this grass here. So increase the yellow here or increase the saturation of the yellow, resulting in this part also being more saturated as well as the curb here. So let's see the before and after of the yellow section of the grass as well as the curb. Here's the before and there's the after. So you just got to be careful when you're selecting colors. It's going to impact different parts of the image, especially if I select the blue, because the blue is the sky. So let's say I want to increase the saturation of the sky. I increased it, but I also selected this, but the image still looks pretty cool. Let's see the before and here's the after. Another option is instead of looking at the HSL sections individually, I can click on all and I can view all the hue sliders, view all the saturation sliders, and view all the luminance sliders. Another way to look at it is also going right here, and instead of HSL, I can select color, and then there's different options so I can target all the orange hue, saturation, and luminance, or I can select all the blue and select all the hue or HSL sliders. There's also this color option here, which gives you all the HSL. So there's just different ways of looking at the color mixer. But another or pretty cool tool is this point color tool right here. And I'm gonna demonstrate that by going in this image right now of Easter Island. I'm just gonna increase the shadows real quickly. Now going back to the color mixer, I click on this eyedropper tool, so I need to sample a color. So I can sample here. Let me see. So, nope, I don't like this. So I'm going to right click, delete the swatch. I'm going to select like a peachy soft color right here. That looks a little bit better. So with this point color, I selected this part of the sky or this color right here. And then I can change the hue. I can change the saturation. And I can change the luminance. And you got to be careful not to overcook it. And if I want to select or change the range of the color or the mask, I can change the range right here. Let's take a look here. And then I can also change it like this. And this is the range. I'm also going to select the range like this. So this is the hue range and this is the saturation range. And it pretty much it makes a mask. And I can view this mask by clicking on visualize range. And I'm just going to give it a maximum range so it doesn't have hard transitions. And let me see here. Looks good. And that looks good. Now I'm going to decrease this. Increase it a little bit here. Get rid of the visualize range. Now I'm going to play around with the HSL right here. I can also change the hue and saturation by moving this around. And then the luminance will be changed by changing this around by going up and down. I'm just going to reset the luminance. Luminance looks good. And let's let's take a look here. So I'm just trying to color grade or make the sky a little bit better. And I'm just moving it around and seeing what looks good. So I'll just keep that this for now. Let's see the before and after. So that doesn't make a big difference. So let me increase the saturation. Now you can see a big difference now in the saturation of the sky, but it does look a little bit cooked. So let me see, I'm just going to change the hue a little bit to make it look a little bit better. Now to complement the sky, what I'm going to do is select the eyedropper tool again. I'm going to select this part of the sky, and then I'm going to make this part of the sky or the blue areas or the blue tones a little bit more purple. So I'm just going to move this point right here. Make it a little bit more purplish, and that looks cool. So depending on how you look at it, this adjustment of the sky or the colors, it may look good to some people and it may not look good to other people, but it's a perfect option or perfect picture to demonstrate this point color tool and the color mixer. So let's take a look at the before of the sky and after of the sky. So what do you guys think of this sky? Did I do a good job? Personally, I would not stick with this, but it definitely helps demonstrate this point color and the color mixer. So anyways, I hope you guys know how to use the color mixer in Lightroom Classic. And if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe, and take a look at my photography on my Instagram account. And as always, live easy, sleep breezy, and stay lovely.